Hello and welcome to part two of the charter train service from Crewe to London Euston by the General Traffic Officer. Today is part two, where we finish the journey off. Now the reason it's been split into two was because when I originally put the whole video together, it was over an hour long. I do apologise sincerely, it's taken me nearly 3-4 weeks to get the second bit out. I do apologise for that, but going forward there will be a video every single week. Now just the amount of videos I've got to do between now and December, there's more than likely going to be two a week. I know, I've not been on YouTube for 4 weeks and now I'm doing what, two a week. Enjoy.
So this is what we got from a reasonably priced, gotta say, buffet car. We got tea, milk and sugar. Check out this ham sandwich. Look at that. Beautiful. Subtotal for that and that, £5.
This one's glaring at me, so let's close the blinds. Just give me a bit of some protection. I'm ginger after all.
Anyway, for me being ginger, let's have a look at what we got from the on-train buffet car, shall we? So, tea, milk and sugar. And look at this ham sandwich. Isn't that lovely? So that, plus that, £5.50. I didn't know that was too badly priced, if I'm honest. I know, traveling golf cup, tea, venal sin, sorry. But, you know, I wanted something a bit different, so I had it. And it's a tipply tea as well. Only the best on this kind of train, isn't it? I'll tell you how the food tastes afterwards, because I'm not putting you through watching me eat.
When that person came before in a really nice suit, and I thought, oh, he's the ticket guy. No. He's the person that comes and picks up your rubbish. Really nice and polite. How was that supposed to be? Back. Really lovely. Maybe small trains right past the other side there. But there is my intercity Tetley tea. We'll let it cool down a bit because it's red hot. Milk and sugar. But yeah, came along, took my rubbish away. Really nice, really, really nice, really nice service. I can't fault the service on this train. It's beautiful, brilliant. They're a credit to Intercity, honestly. If this train was every day, it'd be brilliant. I think if they did it like first thing in the morning, last thing at night, it'd be full. I'm thoroughly enjoying myself, and I think we're just on the outskirts of Birmingham now, so we're not even in the south yet, officially. But yeah, what an amazing journey so far. I'm gonna sit back, enjoy my tea, and watch the world go past my window. But yeah, what a Friday. Friday the 23rd of September, 2022. It's a brilliant Friday. And what a day to film this video on, though. Absolutely amazing. Loving every second of it.
Missed it. That was rugby. The birthplace of the sport, oddly enough. So yeah, we are in the Midlands, officially. I've gone to the station fast once before, that was brilliant. But behind this, I don't know what it is, there's something bewitching about being behind one, the Class 90, it's amazing. It's an amazing, amazing train. But we're flying along, probably near, if not touching, 110 miles an hour.
I'm loving every second of this, I really am. The service has been amazing. They come to your seat, make sure you're all right. They take your rubbish out off your seat, they make sure there's nothing there. The buffet car staff are amazing. When I went for food and drink, because of where we were, my card got declined. But like they said, go back to your seat. If I need to come and find you to pay it, we'll come and find you. They came to my seat, tried to pay for it again, wouldn't accept it again. But it wasn't my card, there was money in the account, don't worry. So what I'm going to do before we get off, I'm going to get down to the buffet car myself and pay for it, because I've got the receipts in my wallet to show that I've paid, or tried to, twice. So yeah, we're going to do that before we get off. I think we'll do it on the approach into Euston, because I really want a video getting off this train, because it is a special, special train. And it's just so nice. And I do love the fact that these actually cover the seat, so if it is sunny, like it was before, not so much now. You can just pull this across the window and it blocks the sun coming in. So yeah, honestly, it's been a really lovely journey. We're just over halfway now, would you say? Maybe a bit more to go. My ears just popped. My ears just went. Went into that tunnel then. That was I wasn't expecting a tunnel. So I don't know if we're gonna go through Birmingham itself or we're gonna go around it. Last time I went through Rugby, I was on the cross country down to Coventry. We went into Birmingham that way, so whether we're gonna go to Birmingham New Street, I don't know. But we'll find out. But so far so good, and yeah, definitely recommend, loving it. When you watch this video, honestly, get a ticket. Either way, London to Crewe or Crewe to London. Well, sorry, London to Manchester, it's a good pass Crewe, doesn't it? But yeah, get a ticket, get on board, and enjoy your service. Yes, it's £75, but it's £75 to ride a piece of British Rail history. I've not been on many heritage full rail tours before. In fact, this is the first one. Not my first one to pick, though, eh? Needs to do a steam one. Definitely needs to do a steam one. That'll probably be either behind Flying Scotsman or Tornado. So that'll be spectacular. But yeah, this has been really good so far. Really enjoyed myself, and it's just been an enjoyable ride so far. But yeah, what I'm going to do is put B-roll in of the British countryside roaring past the window, and if I do see any trains going past, then they'll make it in as well. Look at this carriage. Yes, I'm by myself, but I just love how it's all just really lovely, spaced out. All the seats are the same, proper firm seats, all got the plugs. Pictures of other parts of the Great British Isles with diesel trains at the front of the cars. Of course, any better way to travel apart from steam? No. The Pullman. So luggage carts at both ends. There's a toilet at both ends of each carriage as well. I'm staying within my own carriage because I don't really want to disturb other people's tour of this amazing, on this amazing train. But yeah, it's such a lovely place to be. I mean, even if you're a businessman, you could just plonk, because I've still got full internet signal, even 100 mile an hour. So yeah. You don't get anything complimentary, and yeah, that's probably a markdown, isn't it? But I mean, look, you get a beautiful seat with blind. We're gonna put it back now because it's not as sunny.
You can actually see the buffet car right at the other end of the train as we go around a corner. That's out of a horror film, isn't it? Like an empty train carriage. Ooh, but like that. No. Not about that life. But let's do something we've not done on any other video before. Let's go and have a look at the toilet. That is a decent toilet for a train. Basin, soap dispenser, toilet. Windows blocked, obviously. So yeah, there is a first class toilet. Looks the same as every other toilet, just first class. So yeah, the first ever first class toilet review. Nope. Oh. Spitting bars, obviously. Maybe gonna. Oh, lights come on again. So yeah, you've now seen a first class toilet and a first class carriage. What more could you possibly ask for? Seriously. Three course meal? Nah, can't have one of those. And I would have an alcoholic drink, but this is a YouTube channel. We don't do that kind of thing. I don't drink and vlog at the same time. Bad combination. Yeah, you can get alcoholic beverages on here. There was quite a lot of beer and wine and soft drinks as well. So yeah. We've just cleared the Midlands, so now we're on our final blast down to London. And the payment has now finally gone through. I don't owe them any money. Result! So I've cleared my debts now. No more debts. To the train company. Ever get used to that? We were stationary back then, I wasn't recording, and a pendulum just went past that window, and I pricked it. I was like, what? But yeah. I mean, look at this for a view. Britain looks so much better when it's not raining. Further than I thought we were. We've just gone through a station, but I read it as we went through. Milton Keynes Central. I was like, wow, this train shifted. I didn't expect that. We just washed through and I managed to read the station as we went through, and I was like, Milton Keynes, wow. So we're not far out of London now, are we? About maybe half an hour out, something like that. But it's been an amazing, amazing journey. The weather outside's changed. The vista outside the window's changed multiple times. But I've loved every second of this. It's been an amazing journey on a train that we don't really see that often anymore, unfortunately. You had to make sure there's no branding on that front. But yeah, I've had the carriage all to myself pretty much since we left Crewe. I won't be getting that luxury on the way home, I can tell you that much.
We've just gone through London North Western Railways. So just whistled through Bletchley, I know it was Bletchley. Pendlingers went past, as you saw, hopefully. We just went through London North Western Railways, I think it was their depot. It feels weird saying London North Western Railway, not London North Eastern Railway, or LNER, LNWR, it just feels weird saying that. Need to try them going down to London as well. I know they stop a lot on the way down. But still, you know, it's another train company to try, so yeah, I think train journeys are gonna come on the channel a bit more as well, so yeah, I think we need to try and see more of this country, see more of what different rail companies are like, in this country especially. Oh, and also, breaking news, half the press, the £200 challenge of flying around Europe, seeing where we end up, yep, that's been confirmed, January 2023, yeah. I come back from the States and 3 weeks later I'm on a plane again. Yes. I don't know where I'm going. Well, I know there's two airports we're going to maybe start off at. It's either going to be Gatwick or Stansted. After that, I have got no clue. I'm not booking it. I'll have my missus to book it. But yeah. Two airports I've never been to before, Gatwick and Stansted. One of the two is going to be where we start, I think. So I think the cheapest airport in Britain is Gatwick. On some days it's Stansted, I don't know. But we're going to start there, fly wherever. I think I can probably rule out Russia and Ukraine, for obvious reasons. When I originally came up with the idea, and I spoke to my missus about it as well, Kiev was on the list. Kiev was there. I was like, oh no. Upsetting that. I wanted to go to Kiev and I can't. It's like, but listen, I hope the Ukrainian people, the army, get their country back. I hope they do, because it's their country. But this is not a political channel, so we're not going to go into it. So we might go to Poland, we might go to Turkey. I mean, I watched another channel of that I like watching. I mean, when it comes to trains, I do watch Jeff Marshall a lot. And I watch Noel Phillips when it comes to aviation. And a couple of others. He did a cheap flight challenge and he ended up in Kathmandu. Can you imagine? But the thing for mine is, I start off in Britain and I end up in Britain. But between me leaving Stansted or Gatwick and coming all the way back, I have no idea. Imagine if I ended up in Kathmandu. I don't think they'd let me in somehow. I don't think they'd be like, don't think so, mate, get out. But yeah, that's going to be fun to do. Tunnel. So I think we're on our final approach now. I think we're going to go maybe Watford way and then into London that way, so we might get past Wembley, who knows? But we're going places now.
We're definitely on our final approach into London, which we whistled through Watford Junction, so yeah, this has been an amazing journey. We set off 4 minutes late, we're currently actually on time to arrive into London Euston, so we've made the time up, we're chugging along. We're actually using the same man as overground trains now. We'll just come to an overground station, that was a bit weird. Sadly, there won't be a London series following these videos. I'm not staying in London for any amount of time. I'm literally getting off this train. Probably gonna edit it all and then straight back on train back home. So yeah, no London series at the end of the year, unfortunately. But listen, London is
ready to be explored again. I'm always happy to come down here and see the wonderful capital city of England. It's nice. Coming the week after the Queen's funeral, not going to be as busy, I hope anyway. Although I am in London at peak rush hour, so that's going to be fun. But apart from that, we should be alright. But as I've said before, the guy's come two or three times to pick rubbish out. He's been amazing, really friendly. The staff in the buffet car were amazing. Honestly, can't fault this journey at all. It's been brilliant. Is it going to be Hatch End or Hutch End? Overground station anyway, so... But yeah, we're on the final push into London now, so... Next time we see this mug, we'll be getting off the train. I should be prepared for that, I'm so not. But yeah, thoroughly enjoyed my trip down, and my voice hasn't gone yet, so we're good. £75, yes, you don't get anything complimentary, as I've said, but it's still a wonderful way of travelling. I mean, if you're as lucky as me and you get this for £75, I get an entire coach to myself. Absolutely fantastic. And I've loved every single second of it from the second I got on. Train. Overground, underground station, whistled through there. This has been a brilliant journey. I'm looking out the window, I can see an arch. Yep, we're gonna go past Wembley. So, what a way to end. On the way into London, we're gonna go past, I think it's the biggest national stadium in Britain. I'm not sure about Europe. Oh no, it is in Britain. That hosts football anyway. So, yep, on our final push into London. I'm just waiting to see Wembley appear over there. So yeah, I'll see you when we get to Euston. Not every day you get to do that. Go past Wembley, 110 miles an hour. That's brilliant. I've loved every second of this. It's been beautiful. McVitie's, why are you down here? Why not in lemon juice? That's the North's biscuit, that, McVitie's. It's been brilliant. England, Welsh and Scottish Railway. Seeing sights I don't normally see going into London. For one reason or another. Do you know, outside of Manchester and Stockport, London is my favourite city to come and just do vlogs at, because the tube is the tube, but it's still great to video on it. You learn something new every time you go on it.
can see, we've literally just arrived into London Euston.
Which means I get to do something I've never done before, and I will probably never be able to do again. And that's open a door on a train
by lowering that and opening it from the outside. I just have to wait for that to say door unlocked, because if I open it beforehand, I've technically broken the lock.
I don't know why, but there's something really cool about doing that. But we're here. Pendolino. Going back on one of them in a couple of hours' time. But we're here. It's here. What an amazing, amazing way to travel to the capital. Doesn't she look beautiful? Intercity livery on the back. Front and all gone carriages. The train was amazing. I thoroughly enjoyed myself, and I can't wait to see her again. Well, we'll travel on it next time. Probably just like go to Crewe and watch her leave. This is cool. My two favourite trains, Voyager and Intercity Diesel, next to each other. What an amazing way to finish this video on my birthday. Well, not my birthday, it's 23rd today, it's next Friday. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video as much as I have traveling on that beautiful thing. If you did, please like, share, comment, subscribe, hit the notification bell to miss the video. Me and the coffee cup will see you in the next one when I am 30. Jesus.